What's up, SML? Welcome to another episode of On the Prowl, where we take a look at all things Jaguars from the previous week and take a look ahead to the week to come. So this week, we took on Mike FML and the Packers in Week 10. This was before he really started struggling, and we came in and just right from the beginning, we were dominant. He didn't get too many breaks. Our secondary was breaking on the ball really well. And as you can see, the final score of that game was 41-14. Our big guys from the game, top performers, were Devonta Freeman with 172 yards and a touchdown. Jared Wilson, in his first start since taking over for HaHa Clinton Dix, totaled 4 tackles and 2 interceptions. And then Sidney Jones also had 3 tackles and added another 2 interceptions and a touchdown. And something that's going to be a real common theme for weeks 10, 11, and 12, Jared Wilson and Sidney Jones have both been playing lights out. So week 11, we took on KJ and his Steelers. He was sitting just out of the division lead there in Pittsburgh, and it's been a rough couple of weeks for him, but we were able to go in there, and the defense stepped up. We won 21-3. Winston, 137 yards and 2 touchdowns, but if you look at the bottom of those top performers there, you can see again, Jared Wilson, another 4 tackles and a pick, and then Sidney Jones also had 4 tackles and a pick. So that was our second game of the week, and that made it 2-0 for this week. And then we finished up with week 12. We took on the Browns last night, and we were able to squeak it out 21-13. If you watched the game, you saw we were down the majority of the time. The defense played really well. We didn't give up really anything to the Browns other than a bunch of rushing yards to Nick Chubb. But as soon as they got into the red zone, they were unable to get into the end zone. And our only touchdown we gave up was a Jameis Winston threw a pick right to Grant Delpit, who took it back 6 points. Didn't even break stride on the way back. I mean, it might as well have been thrown to him. But Sidney Jones, again, had an interception. This one he took back for a touchdown. Jared Wilson had another interception early in the game. So the two of them had four interceptions in our 3 games this week. So that was really big for us. Devonta Freeman again, 116 yards. So he topped 100 yards again. And then Taven Bryan had a really big game. He had 4 tackles. 2 of them were huge behind the line stops. One was a sack that caused a forced fumble. We didn't recover it, but it definitely put Woods and the Browns in a 3rd and long that we were able to get another stop on. So it was a big defensive effort for the 2nd week in a row, really 3rd week in a row, because we played really, really well against Mike as well. So the defense looks like it might be starting to pick up speed. That's been our weak spot, but it looks like it's doing a lot better now. Our transactions for this week, not too much going on in the Jaguars front office, other than we did re-sign Sidney Jones to a 5-year, $30 million contract. So pairing him with CJ Henderson for years to come, and hopefully we can develop them into one of the top cornerback tandems in the league. All right, so here's our updated schedule. You can see we have our 3 wins there against Mike, KJ, and Woods. And now our next game is going to be a tough one, though. We got the undefeated Vikings, and we're going to travel to Minnesota and hopefully spoil their undefeated season. But the way he's playing right now, he's just coming off a big win against Royce. So that's going to be a really tough game, but it's going to give us an idea of where we're at. Then we finish up. The last 4 games will be against Coop and the Titans, and I don't even know what he's doing. He's got Tannehill, then he's got his rookie quarterback, then back to Tannehill. The only constant there is Derrick Henry, so hopefully we'll be able to slow him down and get a win there. Then we face NYT and the Ravens. He's playing all right. He's not really blowing anybody out or blowing anybody away right now, so that's a winnable game, but we have to play well. And then Figs and the Bears are kind of an unknown for us right now. We've never played him one scrimmage before the season started, and not even going to go off of that because he's definitely turned it up. He's sitting at 2nd place in the NFC North right now. And then we're going to finish the season against Prime, in which would a game that'll probably decide the AFC North or AFC South. He's got a really, really easy schedule, fairly easy schedule to finish out the season. So we have that game against Faz that's probably going to be a loss. But outside of that, we could end up tied going into week 17. So that's going to be a big game, and we're looking forward to it. All right, so this has been this episode of On the Prowl. be sure to tune in next week to see what happened with probably the Faz game, the Coop game, and the MYT game. All right, guys. Till next time.